Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. And welcome to the Warbucks Theater. I'm Mr. Warbucks. I'm really excited to have all of you here join me in the Big Apple. Now, before we immerse ourselves in the magic of the theater, I have a few notes to review with you from my checklist. So let me check my notes. Oh, I can't seem to find my notes.
Excuse me, Mr. Warbucks. Oh. I think you might be needing this.
Oh, well, thank you. You always know what I need.
Oh, you're welcome, Mr. Warbucks. I don't know what he would do without me.
Well, as I was saying, allow me to give you some information that's necessary from my checklist now that I have it. First and foremost, please turn off your cell phones, or at least put them on silent, as to not disturb your fellow audience members or the cast. Thank you very much. Secondly, the exits are located where the entrances are. Use them in reverse. Even I got that one right. Also, there will be a 15-minute intermission during which refreshments will be available, all for free. Provided graciously, I know, isn't that great? Provided graciously by my Aunt Bella's Bakery. And if you want to visit a bakery afterwards, she's over here right on 8th and Broadway. Also, the restrooms are located down that way by the pool, both men's and women's. Please use the restrooms, not the pool. My staff frowns on that. Also, as always, please feel free to mingle with the cast at the end of the show. We'll be available for you. I'd like to thank our crew and our cast for their hard work and dedication to this show that we've been rehearsing for almost 3 months, learning songs and chorus choreography and lines and doing it all. Anyway, I think you're in for a real treat. You're gonna like it here. Now sit back and relax and prepare to be entertained by the world premiere of GrAnnie the Musical. Enjoy the show!
My sciatica's acting up again. Oh, yeah. How you doing? All right. Where's my newspaper?
I got it.
Thank you.
Oh, no.
No news is good news, that's what I always say. Oh, jeez.
Remember,
play your hand.
What? I can't hear you.
Well, turn up your hearing aid, laddie.
There's my suppository.
What's a suppository doing in your bleeding ear?
I'm not sure, but I think I know where my hearing aid is.
Okay, laddie, come on. We're not getting any younger. Keep going.
Okay, here you go. I got it. Three aces and two
boils on my ass. What do you want to see?
I don't want to see that.
I'm just so sick and tired of being sick and tired.
My doctor said that I should be
dead. Oh my God. Your tomato garden is dead.
It's those damn rats. They eat everything. They even ate my
grandchildren. They never run around. I just wish that once they would.
Go to hell. I saw you cheating.
Who do you call a cheater, you son of a...
Biscuit! I have such a picky dog, the only thing he eats is...
Zoloft. My doctor said I need to take Zoloft for my...
Boils, rashes, and gout!
Oh, my!
Boils, rashes, and gout!
Oh, my!
Boils, rashes, and gout! Oh, my!
Oh, my God!
What are you old people complaining about now?
Who are you calling old?
You!
You know, if you don't quiet down, we're gonna get in trouble with Miss Hannigan.
What?
Not you, Miss Hannigan. I was talking about Miss Hannigan.
What?
Not you, Miss Hannigan. I was talking about your daughter, Miss Hannigan.
What?
Nothing, Miss Hannigan.
Maybe we just better freeze here so I could explain some things to you. Welcome to Miss Hannigan's rundown home for the old and the hopeless. No, not this Miss Hannigan. She ran an orphanage here 60 years ago. I was talking about her daughter, who's even worse than her mother was. When old Miss Hannigan got sick of running that orphanage and sick of those little girls, she kicked them all out on the street and she opened up a retirement home called Sunset Meadows. Miss Hannigan still lives here, but most of the time she doesn't even know it. These are some of our residents. This is Mildred, she's my best friend. This is Herbert, he's been here longer than any one of us. He's a little grumpy, but I know how to handle him. And this is Herman, he's one of my favorites. He hears only half of what he says. And Miss Hannigan, that's running the place now, is a mean old grump who never made anything of her life. She lives to make everyone else miserable and drinks to forget how miserable her life really is. And me, I just can't wait to get out of here any way that I can, as fast as I can. By the way, my name is Betty James, but since I take care of everyone here, everyone calls me GrAnnie.
All right, Settle down.
You know, I could hear you all the way down the block.
Down the block? Did you sneak out again?
You're the one who's going to get in trouble with Miss Hannigan.
What?
Nothing, Miss Hannigan.
I'm not worried about old Miss Hannigan. She's half drunk half the time and all the way drunk the rest of the time. Besides, I only sneak out when she's passed out. Hey guys, don't you ever get tired of bingo and stale cookies?
Hey, Lassie, we know you all slip out of here tonight and go out in the city and see if you can find Mr. Wright.
Don't you mean Mr. Wright now?
Yeah. No, she means Mr. Wright me a check.
And what's wrong with that? What's wrong if I don't want to spend the rest of the best years of my life here? It's okay, you guys are content to stay here in God's waiting room. But me, I want to get out there and see the world. And if I happen to be walking down the street one day, and maybe Mr. Wright is walking down the street, and maybe our eyes meet, and maybe we fall in love, and maybe we get married, and maybe he's a billionaire with a mansion on Park Avenue. What's wrong with that? And maybe...
Maybe I'm happy and everyone knows.
fine. Please make it real. I don't have much time.
Now this prayer's the last one of its kind. Please come and marry your baby.
Miss Hannigan.
Yes, Miss Hannigan.
Yeah, whatever.
Chopped liver?
No, Herman, I like chopped liver.
Thank you.
Think of us as a bad rash. Annoying, but hard to get rid of. I love you guys. You're my only family, but there's nothing that you can do to help me.
If we put our heads together, we can think of a way to get you out of here. And into somewhere better.
Somewhere better? I can't afford somewhere better.
You could if you got a job.
A job? I haven't haven't had a job in forever. I wouldn't even know where to start. I don't even know what I'm good for anymore. What kind of job could I get?
Says right here in these here want ads that someone is looking for a nanny.
I hate kids.
Dog walker?
I hate dogs.
Pole dancer? Point taken. Well, let's see. There is this up-and-coming computer company that is hiring computer techs to write some programs. I don't know, it says something about apples or something, I don't know.
Computer tech? I don't know anything about computers or apples.
Oh, wait. Hold on. It says right here that the name of the company is called Apple Computers.
Apple Computers? What a stupid name for a company. Mark my words, in 1 year, they'll be gone. As a matter of fact, I hear that after this Y2K thing, all computers will be obsolete.
Oh, wait, right here. It says that that billionaire over on Park Avenue, you know, the one his father passed away, Mr. Warbucks, well, his son inherited the whole company and the mansion. And he is hiring a personal chef.
Personal chef? Granny can't cook.
Yeah, the only thing she knows how to make are reservations.
Personal chef to Mr. Warbucks, huh?
Granny, are you thinking about that? You know, if you tried to cook, you'd probably burn the mansion down trying to make toast. Right?
Did you ever hear of fake it till you make it? Besides, it's not the job that I'm after.
No.
Well, what are you talking about?
Well, if I could get hired, then I could get close to Mr. Warbucks. In case you guys haven't noticed, I am highly irresistible.
What?
I may not be able to turn on the stove, but I think I still can turn on a billionaire.
So you don't want to be a chef?
No, you don't understand. This is my ticket out of here. If I could get hired by Mr. Warbucks, then I can get close to him, and then it's only a matter of time before we fall in love and he proposes and I become a billionaire wife on Park Avenue.
You know what, Granny? I think you might just be on to something there.
What am I talking about? Look at me. What is a rich, wonderful, handsome billionaire going to see in me? I'm old, I'm poor, and I'm falling apart.
Who is it?
Nah. I'm never going to get that job. I'm never going to get hired. Never going to get married. Going to be stuck here with you guys until I die.
Oh, stop that stinking thinking. We're going to help you get that job.
And you know what? We got to get you ready. You're going to need a resume and a new outfit. And some etiquette lessons.
Etiquette lessons? Who the hell needs etiquette lessons? I got more class coming out of my ass than a teacher with a classroom full of dummies.
What does that even mean?
Oh, I'm giving up. It's just not going to work. I'm not going to get hired. I'm not going to do any of those things. I'll be stuck here for the rest of my life.
Enough already. We're going to help you get that job, get ready for the interview, and the rest is up to you.
Well, you better hurry. It says right here that the interviews for the job are tomorrow.
Tomorrow?
Tomorrow!
We'll never be ready in time.
Myself.
Day, that's great.
365 days, weekends off, that's 104 times 8. Subtract Christmas, New Year's, and my birthday, and oh yeah, when those 3 days that you gave me to visit my niece in Minneapolis for her graduation, did I ever thank you for that?
Yes.
Well, accounting for leap years and carry the 7, that would be 2,059 times, Mr. Warbucks.
Well, let's just make it 2,060 now. Mr. Warbucks was my father. Please, call me William.
Yes, Mr. Warbucks.
Do you have something for me?
Yes, these are the quarterly figures that you requested.
I see. Just as I figured. We have a problem here, Alfred. Manufacturing costs have gone up, and our profits continue to plummet. You know, ever since my father passed away and I inherited the business, I just can't seem to live up to the standards that he had for me. I'm just not the businessman that dear old Daddy Warbucks was.
Have you considered calling your sister Annie and asking for her help?
You know I love my sister, and we both know my father loved her very much. I mean, that's why he adopted her. But, you know, we never really saw eye to eye on how we would run my father's business. So Annie took her inheritance and sold her half the business to me. And then she went off and retired in the Cayman Islands.
Not to be rude, sir, but why are you telling me all the stuff I already know?
It's called backstory, Alfred. I need to let the audience know what has happened over the last 60 years.
Oh, yes, of course.
Excuse me, Mr. Warbucks.
Hope. What have I told you about that?
Oh, forgive me. William, I have some documents that require your signature. Is now a good time? If not, I'm happy to come back later.
No, no. It's okay. Stay. What did I just sign?
Oh, nothing much. You just gave me a very big raise. Just kidding, William. It's about the donations you approved for the repairs and renovations for the orphanage.
Oh, that's right.
Yes. And this one here is your acceptance to President Bill Clinton's dinner party. Oh. He's going to be introducing his new intern.
His new intern. Why don't you send him a box of cigars from me? You know, Hope, what would I do without you?
Fail miserably.
Yes.
And miss out on a very good dinner.
Mm-hmm.
But seriously, William, you're the most generous employer I've ever worked for. You're not like your father, but that's your best quality.
Well, thank you, Hope. You know, I'm lucky to have you. I really think you're overqualified to be my secretary. I hope you never plan on leaving me.
Well, I'm not going anywhere.
Well, good. Was there anything else?
No. Oh, actually, yes. There's an interview waiting for you in the foyer. Oh. She's here for the chef position.
Oh, okay. Well, thank you, Hope.
You're welcome, William. Mm-hmm.
Good afternoon, Mr. Wogbutts.
Should I let the young lady in?
Sanjay, what happened to the old chef? You know, the loud British one.
Well, sir, Chef Gordon Ramsay, he quit. He moved down to Hell's Kitchen to open up his own restaurant.
Mm. Well, I wish him the very best. I'm definitely going to miss his beef Wellington. You know, everything he made was top-notch.
Yeah, he was quite the chef. But I have to tell you this, Mr. William. The rest of the staff is so happy that he's gone.
Oh.
He had quite the temper and the vocabulary. He would be saying effing this and effing that all the time. He would throw pots and pans at the sous chefs. The cleaning crew would often have to spend after hours to clean up his gourmet mess.
Mm.
At one time, I even found a live lobster up in the chandelier.
Oh, wow.
I believe I speak for the entire staff when I politely say, good riddance, you effing bastard! pardon my friends, Mr. William. I'll bring her in.
Yeah, well, thank you, Sanjay. Yes. Why don't you let her in?
Yes, yes. Come on in, please. Mr. Wogbutts? Miss Betty James.
Oh, well, Miss James, please have a seat.
Oh, my mother was Miss James. You can call me Granny. Everyone calls me Granny.
Well, in that case, Granny, I'm William. It's a pleasure to meet you. Well, I was looking at your resume here. It's very, very impressive. You studied at the University of Chefs.
Yes. I was the top chef in my class. I out-chefed everyone. I was the chef valedictorian then.
Oh, I see. Well, why don't you tell me about a little of your chefing experience?
Experience?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I have that. I surely have chefing experience. Well, let's see. I have chefed with the best. I have chefed all over the world. I've even chefed in third world countries where they didn't even know what chefing was until I showed up. I even wrote the book on chefing. I did. Chefing from here to eternity. I can tell you stories about some of the most famous people that I chef for.
Oh, really? Like who?
Who?
Yeah.
Who? Well, how much time do you have?
All the time we need.
Oh, good. Okay, well then, let's see. I know I once chefed for the president.
The President of the United States of America.
Yeah, that one. That's the guy. I even chef for the Yankees. You know, they didn't sell hot dogs until I came chefing around.
You did all that?
I did? Oh, yes, I did. I sure can chef.
Well, I've heard enough.
You have?
Yes.
I understand. I'll just show myself out. Thank you for your time, Mr. Warbucks.
Oh, please, call me William. Everybody that works for me calls me William.
Works for you? Do you mean, did you say that
I... Well, with chefing experience like yours, why wouldn't I hire you? The job is yours. You start right away. You do want the job, don't you?
Oh yes, yes, Mr. Warbucks. I mean, yes, William, I mean... Yes, I do. I mean, I do.
Well, that's wonderful. I think you're going to fit in just perfect. Why don't we go meet the staff? GrAnnie, since you're new here, I'd like to introduce you to my staff. This is my secretary, Hope.
I have to pick out all his clothes.
I can dress myself, you know.
His bath is drawn by Mrs. Bubbles, I think, surely comes in to make his bed. I think I'm gonna like it here. The swimming pool is to the left.
Inside the house? Oh boy!
The kitchen is right over here.
Can't we just order pizza?
He likes to have his lunch at noon.
Just tell me what you need.
I think I'm gonna like it here. When he wakes, ring for Drake. Drake will bring his tray. When he's through, Mr. Pugh comes to take it away.
We sure can't wait to taste your food.
You better lower your expectations.
We sure are glad that you are here.
We have but one request. Please put us to the test.
I know I'm gonna like it here.
Used to room in a tomb where I'd sit and freeze.
Watch me now. Holy cow! Would someone pinch me, please? Oh, it's just an expression.
We've never had a chef like you.
I'm very glad to volunteer.
We hope you understand. Your wishes are command.
We know you're
gonna like it.
Mr. Warbucks has requested dinner in 15 minutes.
15 minutes? Well, I don't even know what I'm going to make, and I don't even know where the kitchen is. Hope I'm never going to be able to do this. Help me, help me.
Right this way, Miss GrAnnie. I wouldn't worry too much. William isn't a very picky eater.
Oh, dear.
Your dinner, sir.
Well, GrAnnie, creation looks interesting.
I call it Surprise Symphony. A myriad of flavors guaranteed to tantalize your taste buds.
It's certainly unique. perhaps a bit on the adventurous side.
I'm sorry.
Oh, look, don't be. You know what? How about we ditch this questionable cuisine and we go out for a real dinner? It'll be my treat.
Really? It wouldn't be too much trouble?
Not at all. Besides, maybe you can give me some pointers on what actual food should taste like. A table for two, please.
Oh, I'm sorry. We're full up for the night, and we don't have anything available for probably about 3 weeks.
Are you sure?
Yes, sir.
Oh, that's okay, Mr. Warbucks. I know of a great little hot dog stand right down the street. They even let you sit on those cute little wooden crates.
Oh.
Excuse me, Mr. Warbucks. I'm so sorry. You have to excuse me, please. Anyway, your usual table is ready if you want to follow me.
Thank you. Wow, you must eat here a lot.
Not really. You see, I own the place. The food is tolerable, but the service sucks.
Well, I've never eaten, I've never chefed in a fancy place like this.
Well, don't you worry. What have you got?
Good evening, Mr. Bucks.
Yeah, good evening.
May I interest you in our delectable specials tonight? We have a pan-seared salad with a rosemary-infused beurre blanc, or succulent rack of lamb seasoned with garlic, lemon zest.
Oh, beurre blanc and rosemary rack of lamb. I wouldn't even know where to start.
Don't worry, GrAnnie. Why don't you leave the culinary complexities to me? I'll have the pan-seared salmon, please, medium rare.
All right, thank you. And for you, ma'am?
How about the chicken, but not too spicy. Chicken's safe, right?
Safe? How about we try something a little more adventurous? How about the seared scallops with saffron risotto? Oh,
saffron risotto? Isn't that expensive?
Consider it a reward for surviving my kitchen earlier. And to pair with our meals, a bottle of your favorite.
My favorite?
Yes.
My favorite what?
Wine, my dear. Your favorite wine. What's your favorite wine?
Oh, no. I don't have a favorite wine.
Oh, of course you do. Every woman has a favorite wine. They're just waiting for it to be discovered. Allow me to surprise you. A bottle of Chateau Lafite Rothschild.
Oh, Rothschild. What year, sir?
The best we have.
Oh, the best year. All right, sir, we'll have that for you shortly.
So, why don't you tell me a little bit about yourself?
Well, there's not much to tell. I once chefed for the Queen of England.
No. I don't want to know what's on your resume. I want to know what's not on your resume.
Oh, okay. Well, I was married for 52 years to a wonderful man named Oscar. Mm-hmm. We never had any children, and he traveled all over with his job, and I went along with him.
Oh. So when did you have time to go to culinary school?
Huh? What's that?
Oh. Excuse me, I meant chefing
school. Oh, yes, chefing school. Well, I went to chefing school when...
It's okay, GrAnnie. I know you lied on your resume.
You do?
Yes.
I'm sorry, Mr. Warbucks.
Yeah, it's okay.
Here you are. Folks, here's your wine. A Rothschild. Mm-hmm. Enjoy it.
Why don't you just take the dinner out of my salary?
Oh, come on. That won't be necessary. Besides, everybody lies on their resume. You remember Sanjay, right?
Your butler?
Well, he was a belly dancer for the Bollywood stars when I first met him.
Oh my.
Look, I didn't hire you because of your experience or lack of. I hired you because I thought you'd bring a sense of freshness and light into my household.
Oh my, well, I've been called a lot of things, but never a light. Thank you, Mr. Warbucks.
Oh, please, call me William.
William. No, that doesn't suit you. I think I'm gonna call you Billy.
All right, well, Granny, it's very, very nice to meet you.
The pleasure is all yours. Yes, Miss Hannigan. I mean, thank you, Miss Hannigan. Mm-hmm.
I have been a little tired lately.
That's because you're old. You know, you should not be out working in the hot sun all day for some money-hungry tyrant. You know, that Mr. Warbucks is taking advantage of a tired old woman who can barely stand up. Mm-hmm, he is. You know, at your age, you should be retired and enjoying playing bingo with your friends every day until you die.
But I like my job.
No, you don't. Well, why don't you go see my doctor and we will see what he says. And while you're there, maybe he can fix that hump. Oh. Hey, Rooster, it's your sister. I need a favor.
All right, so our patient should be here shortly. Now, you just do whatever I say and try not to screw up.
Yes, Rooster. I mean, yes, Doctor.
Now, you remember where everything is?
Yes.
And you remember where everything goes?
I think so, but the point hand goes where again?
Never mind that. She's here.
Well, hello there, Miss Granny. I am Dr. McGillicuddy. Thank you for being on time for your appointment. And this is my highly trained assistant nurse, Ruby.
Have a seat. I'm just here for a checkup.
Checkup, shmeckup. You're sick, I can tell. I'm a doctor. Symptoms galore, I presume?
No, not really. I just need a checkup to see if I'm well enough for my new job.
New job? And your delicate condition? Nonsense.
Oh.
Have a seat. And Nurse Ruby, fetch me the chart. We're going to assess the damage.
The damage chart?
That's the one.
Right away, Dr. McDougal.
Fine. Now, Granny, you just sit back, relax, and we'll get down to the bottom of this illness that you have. Now first, can you read the bottom line of that chart on that wall?
What chart? What wall?
Classic symptom. Degenerative wall blindness. Note the anomaly.
Walls, blindness, got it. No, Doctor, I think that there's a misunderstanding. I feel perfectly fine.
Blood pressure, Ruby! Oh. Fetch me the inflatable thingy and make it snappy. Very good. All right, we're just gonna take your blood pressure here.
Doesn't that go on my arm?
Now who's the doctor here?
I think you're doing it wrong. I think he's doing it wrong.
Oh, this is bad.
No. Yes.
All right. Oh, very bad. All right. Open up and say, yeah. Very, very bad indeed. Yes, yes, very bad. Very bad. We should take your temperature.
Oh, I know how to do that. You're gonna have to bend over, sweetie.
Oh, it's not that kind of a thermometer.
But doctor, I really think that I'm fine, and I think I better take my well-being.
You're gonna check your reflexes.
No,
Ruby, fetch me the reflex refluxer.
Reflex refluxer.
The hammer.
The reflex refluxer. Stat.
You don't say stat. I say stat.
What do I say?
Nothing.
Oh.
All right, now you just tell me if this hurts.
To the bottom of what is bothering her. Do you have the diagnosis to the, what was it again?
The blindness, floating ankle disease.
Right. The test results, please.
We have your test results right here, Miss GrAnnie. I know exactly what's ailing you. Schizophrenic paranoia, that's your diagnosis. Even though the sound of it, something quite atrocious. You have trauma to the brain, led to your psychosis. Schizophrenic paranoia, that's your diagnosis. Something is, you're gonna die! You're gonna die! You're gonna die! Also some anxiety, depression, scoliosis, partial blindness, mania, osteoporosis. Sorry, no, GrAnnie Sit has a poor prognosis!
Then what should we prescribe her?
Just a spoonful of Prozac helps the Adderall go down. The Trazodone go down, the lithium go down. Just a spoonful of Xanax helps the Lexapro go down in the most delightful way. Side effects? Of course they will. Side effects that may occur are headaches, diarrhea, dizziness, nausea, maybe gonorrhea. Like the death of memory, schizophrenic paranoid, that's your diagnosis. Schizophrenic paranoid, that's your diagnosis.
I'm out of here.
Obsessed with regularity.
So wait until she finds out they're serving cream cauliflower for lunch.
Oh, there's gonna be more explosions than on the 4th of July.
It's cold in here. Can somebody please close the door?
War? Did somebody say war? Oh, we had a war back in my day, let me tell you.
There, there, Herman. We all know you were a war hero. Now, where were we?
We're talking about Mildred's digestive issues.
Good morning, my darlings. Mm-hmm. Has anybody seen the mailman? I'm expecting an important letter from my grandkids.
Oh, you know, Miss Hannigan's the only one allowed to get the letters out of the mailbox. One time, I was down in the basement looking for blankets, and there were tons of boxes down there. They were full of old junk mail and unpaid bills. I think she hides our letters from our family down there. I think she's a hoarder, a letter hoarder.
Border? Did somebody say border? Remember when I crossed the border into Mexico in 47? Best tequila I ever had.
Oh,
that's a darn good tequila.
Dr. Rooster's feel-good emporium.
Oh, shut the clock off, Rooster.
Who is it, sweetie?
It's my sister. Now, shh. Hey, sis, how's tricks?
You blew it for the old lady. We have to come up with a new plan. Get yourself and your idiot girlfriend over here right away.
We'll be right there.
Okay.
Well, that was fast.
That's what I keep telling
them. Hey, Ruby, sweetheart, you do me a favor?
Sure, anything.
Sit down, look pretty, and shut up, huh?
Okay.
My best performances. Did the old lady fall for it and quit her job over at the billionaire's?
You are the worst con man I know.
You're the worst big sister I know.
And you're the worst baby brother I know.
You got the worst taste in clothes.
Well, you got the worst taste in girlfriends.
Fiance!
What?
Tim Rooster tell you? He popped the question. I'm gonna be Mrs. Rooster.
Hey, Chicken Little.
It's true, sis. Baby brother's gonna fly straight, do right, and settle down. Might even have myself a couple little rugrats. I want to get Ruby out of this no-good town. Buy her a nice house with a
white picket fence.
You got it, babe. I just need to pull off one more big job.
Listen up, the both of you. I can't let the old lady move out. She continues spending time with that jerk of a billionaire, then he might fall for her. And if that happens, you know, we will not be able to get our hands on the $15 billion that her uncle left her. She doesn't even know about it yet, because I'm the only one who reads the mail.
You sure are smart, sis. The way you hide all of their family's letters from them, that way they don't think anybody cares about them. And then they continue living here. You get all of their government money and their retirement funds. You're a genius.
That's kept us afloat for this long. I just have to find a way to keep you long enough till I can do away with her when nobody will notice.
But if you kill her, you'll never get her money. There's a flaw in your plan there, sis.
Oh, fiddlesticks. Well, if we can't kill her, then how are we gonna get to her money?
Get her to fall in love with you.
What did she say?
Get her to fall in love with Rooster. Then knock her off. Marry her, knock her off, and then you'll get all her money legally.
Ruby, you're a genius. I love you.
No. How are we going to get her to fall in love with Rooster? She's already fallen for Warbucks. What has Rooster got that a handsome, intelligent, successful billionaire hasn't?
Me? I'll pose as a speed dating planner. I'll set the old lady up, you know, with some of my friends. I bet she won't fall in love with
real losers.
She'll be so bored with them that by the time she meets my Rooster, she won't be able to resist him.
Yeah, but how are you gonna get her to agree to go speed dating? You heard her. She's already fallen for the billionaire.
Now you leave that to me. When it comes to manipulating the elderly, there's nobody better than good old Miss Hagenin. No, Rooster, your marriage to the old lady is the quickest route to Easy Street.
I remember the way I said it, Mother. Would sit and croon us her lullaby.
She'd say, kids, there's a place that's like no other. You gotta get there before you die.
You don't get there by playing by the rule books.
Ha ha! You stack the aces.
Yeah.
You look at
case. Mother dear, oh, we know you're in there listening. How can we follow your sweet advice? Easy Street, where you sleep till noon.
Yeah. She repeats.
I'll live the lush life.
Easy Street.
I'll live the plush life. Then I get there. Easy Street. for 3 or 4 bucks while she gets $4.
The moldy bat. It ain't fair, this here life is driving me nuts. While we get peanuts, she's living fast.
Maybe she is the key, that little lady.
To get more bucks.
Yeah.
Instead of less.
Maybe we fix the game with something shady.
Where does that put us?
Oh, tell us.
If you want game.
Yes.
Easy street. Easy street. Granny is the key.
Yes, sorry.
Ha! Come on, Seth! We'll live the lush life! We'll live the plush life! That's where we're gonna be!
Your favor, go wait in the car. I gotta have a word with my sis.
I don't want to wait in the car by my lonesome. I want to be here with you.
Just do what I say, please. You can go start making some lists.
Okay, I'll go make a list of losers. Don't be long.
I want my little smoochy poo. I can't wait to get rid of that dame. She's really ruffling my feathers, you know what I mean?
I knew it! I knew you couldn't possibly be falling for that dizzy chicken leg, little tramp.
How'd you know?
I knew it the moment she said you proposed. I'm your big sister. I know you better than anyone.
So, you want to know my game?
Yeah, what's your game?
I've been playing that dame since day one. When I met her at the horse track, she was putting a bad bet on the wrong horse. I knew she was green and would make the perfect patsy. So I thought I'd play the loving type, make her fall in love with me. That way I could have a new look, a new image, look respectable.
No one would suspect a family man of pulling a big job. Ah, you're a genius rooster.
Now, as soon as she helps us get the old lady's money, I get rid of her, and you and I split the money 50-50.
Then we burn this place to the ground and collect the insurance payout.
What about Mama and the rest of them fossils?
Oh, don't go all soft on me. Nobody cares about them. Besides, you know Mama, she never loved us anyway. Trust me, haven't I always looked out for my baby brother? This place gone, I'll finally be rid of this crappy life.
And we'll be living large on Easy Street. You sure are genius. Ah, sis, I better go check on Ruby, make sure she hasn't locked herself in the car again. I love you, sis.
Oh, I love you too, baby brother.
Easy Street.
What a moron! After he marries Granny and dumps the dumb blonde, that's when my real plan kicks in. While he's down in the basement, lighting a fire, I'm gonna lock the door behind him and be long gone with all the money before anyone can say, Kentucky Fried Chicken, extra crispy! You know, by this time next week, I will be mayor of Easy Street. Population 1. Easy Street. Granny is the key. Yes, sorry.
Lucy Lovelace.
I'm Lucy Lovelace. Tonight you'll be meeting five eligible bachelors who are licking the love, just like you are. Each of these men have been handpicked by yours truly from the matchmaking database. I have screened each and every one of these fine gentlemen, and I trust each of you will find that special someone who will sweep you off your feet and out of your old boring life. Your exciting adventure awaits you. You'll notice that each of you has a set of questions in front of you. Feel free to use those questions to interview your prospective suitor. Each man will have 2 minutes to make a good first impression and hopefully win your heart. After 2 minutes, you'll hear a bell ring. That means it's time to switch suitors. Ladies, are you ready to start your speed dating adventure?
Yes.
Bring in the first three gentlemen.
Hello, I'm Anthony.
Anthony, hello, Anthony. Can I call you Tony?
No. Well, please excuse me. I'm awfully nervous. I haven't ever done this before. But my mother said I really need to get out more, so here I am.
Oh, you take care of your mother.
Well, not exactly. After my fourth divorce, I moved into my mother's basement, and now she's saying I either need to get a job or find a woman to take care of me. But I can't get a job because of my extensive police record. So here I am.
Oh, okay. Well, Anthony, would you excuse me for just 1 second? Thank you.
I prefer to stand.
Oh, okay, then I'll stand with you.
I think I'll sit down.
Okay, we'll sit down. So, what's your name?
Why do you need to know that? Who are you working for? What's the third degree?
Well, you're here at a speed dating event. I assume that you're here to meet people, and it's hard to do that without answering questions, but... Okay, let's just start over. I'm Betty, but everyone calls me Granny.
So Granny is your code name. Very clever. Yeah, let's use code names just in case someone's listening. You can call me Old Turkey Buzzard. Don't read that. It might be a spite.
Oh, I certainly hope so.
Why are you waving out to that lady? Why? Is that some sort of a signal?
No. I just really need a drink, waitress. Yes, can I get a rum and coke? Hold the coke.
The eagle lands on the moon in June. The eagle lands on the moon in June.
Alrighty then. Better make it a double.
Oh. Why are you so oblivious of what's going around here? They're probably bugged every table. They're probably listening to us. They're watching us. They're watching our every move. Who are you really?
Security!
Vigo's name. How are you doing, Toots?
Toots. Oh, okay. I have some questions here. Why don't we just start with those?
Right, shoot.
Okay, if you could take me on the perfect date, where would we go?
Oh, that's easy. My mama makes the best linguine in Brooklyn. I would bring you home to meet her and the family. My brother Mario, he would just love you. You remind me of his third wife. She was a firecracker, I tell you. One time she caught Mario in bed with her sister. Well, let's just say she won't be at a family reunion for 10 to 15 years if she gets good behavior. Oh, then there's my Uncle Guido, just don't look him in the eye. My sister Annabella, you'll get along with her. I mean, everybody does. And believe me when I say everybody has loved her at least once. She invented the speed dating, if you know what I mean. Bada bing, bada boom. Thank you, leave the money on the dresser. Oh, you gotta try my Aunt Bella's antipasto. It'll make your mouth water, your tongue tingle, and your toes curl. She even entered Brooklyn's best antipasto contest, but would you believe it? She lost to her junior high school best friend, Gherky. And that was a day, remember, they haven't talked to each other since.
Your dad?
He's dead.
Oh.
Monday, I get my carpal tunnel. What about you?
Well, compared to you, I'm perfect. Listen, we've got some questions here. Why don't we do those since we have 2 minutes to kill?
I don't kill. Oh, don't, please don't say that word. Besides, your voice is so shrill, I need to turn my hearing aid down a little bit so I can hear those questions.
Okay. Oh, here's a good one. If you could be any kind of animal, what animal would you be? Turn your hearing aid back up.
There, is that better?
Yes.
Okay, all right.
Here's a better one.
Okay.
If you could go anywhere in the world, where would you go?
To the hospital.
Do you have any hobbies?
Oh, yes. Sure.
Oh, good. Well, what are they?
Well, every day I take my pills out and I organize them in color-coded order so that they're nice and neat for the day's time. So, could I ask you a question?
Sure.
Oh, yeah. Okay, good. Do you think this mole looks suspicious?
Okay, women. This is your last date.
Make it a good one.
Hola, señorita.
Hello.
Do you mind if I sit down for a moment?
No, please do.
Ay, qué bonita. I have never seen such beautiful eyes since the Betty Davis. Are you an actress?
No, I'm not an actress. But my name is Betty.
Ay, Betty, such a beautiful name. Me amores, Enrique.
Enrique.
Si, named after my father. Enrique San Antonio Hernandez Iglesias Fernando II. Named after his father. Enrique San Antonio Hernandez Iglesias Fernando the First.
Well, Enrique, why don't you tell me a little bit about yourself?
I know. Ladies first, I insist, please.
Okay. Well, let's see. Well, there's not much to tell, but
very good. I will go there. I was born from a very poor family, you see. The youngest of 15. When we moved from España to here, like you, I have found love and lost. It was only 10 years ago that my beautiful Maria passed from me. See, God bless her soul. But only recently, I have found a letter that she wrote to me upon her deathbed. She wrote, Enrique, please find love once again, for I do not want for you to be alone. Love, Maria. So, here I am.
Oh, my. Well, I'm so sorry for your loss. Are you retired now?
Gracias. Pero no, I take care of mi mama.
Oh.
See, she is very old and not doing so good.
Oh, I'm sorry.
My brothers and sisters, they want to throw her away in one of those group homes where they treat you no so good.
Oh, I know about that.
But I say, no, I will take care of mi mama. So, I buy her a beautiful casita by the ocean front so she can watch the sunrise and sunset. And also, I build her a beautiful greenhouse so that I can pick fresh flowers for her and bring them to her every morning when I bring her her breakfast in bed.
Oh, my. You sound like a wonderful son.
Is it because I am, Chess?
Your mother is a lucky woman.
I know, Chess.
Can I ask you a question?
But of course.
Why speed dating?
I have been asking myself that very question all the night long.
Yeah.
And all that I could think of is that there must be someone or something bigger than all of us out there looking out for me. I had a need, no, a desire to be here tonight, almost as if my future depended upon it, as if I was to find the one I am to spend the rest of my life with, here, tonight, in this very place. Maybe, just maybe.
Maybe.
I am so sorry that our date was cut short. I was wondering if it would not be so bold of me to ask, would you like to have dinner with me sometime?
Oh, yes, I would really like that.
Wonderful. I shall pick you up at your place Friday night.
Oh, no, not my place. I work on Friday. Pick me up there. Here's the address. And would you pick me up at...
That's sneaky.
Yeah. 7:00
Friday. I cannot wait to be graced by your presence once again. Adios, señorita.
Sayonara.
Mr. Warbucks has been out every night this week.
I know. When he comes home, I hear him singing in his office.
Singing?
Yeah.
See?
singing. Have you ever known him to sing?
No. Only a man in love can sing like that.
Yeah. Do you have any idea who he sings or where they're going?
Not a clue. Oh.
What are you two ladies gossiping about this time?
Oh, we were just wondering who Mr. Warbucks has been seeing every night this week.
I know something that you two don't know.
You know who the mystery woman is?
If you know, you better tell us right now.
I'm not going to spill the cats. I'm not going to let the leaves out of the bag. My eyes are sealed.
Well, we'll just tell Mr. Warbucks that we've seen you sneaking down into the wine cellar, having your own little wine tasting party with Alfred.
You don't you dare, because I'll tell him how you two take his Rolls Royce out for a joyride when he's out of town.
Oh, did you forget you're the one that drives us?
Only to make sure that you two don't do anything stupid.
Who are you calling stupid?
What stupid is a stupidness?
If you know who you have
stupid, tell her who is right now.
No, I'm not going to tell you that Mr. Warbucks is going out to Miss GrAnnie.
GrAnnie?
How did you know?
What is all this commotion about? Get back to work, all of you.
Yes, Miss Ellis.
I was just going over the menu for next week.
Yes, that's correct. We were not talking about Mr. Warbucks going out with Miss GrAnnie.
How did you know?
Well, how did you know?
I know everything that goes on here. I am the eyes and ears of this house.
Well, maybe you should have used your mouth and told us.
Well, it looks like somebody already...
Don't look at me. I know nothing. I see nothing. I hear nothing.
I haven't seen William this happy in years. He really makes GrAnnie laugh.
He laughed? You actually heard him laugh?
Oh, yes. And I think she's really good for him. She seems to really like it here, and I'm just hoping she's going to stay on. I've also noticed that we are all smiling and laughing more since she's been here. So she just is like a ray of sunshine. Enough gossiping. Laverne, go and make dinner, please.
Yes.
And Shirley, don't you have some beds to make or something else?
Ladies!
Oh. How do I look?
Oh, amazing. Look at that dress.
You look like you just stepped out of a Broadway musical.
No,
it's perfect. No. Mr. Warbucks is going to love it.
Oh, Mr. Warbucks. Yes, I hope he does. I always wanted to go red. I just want to be someone else for a change.
Miss GrAnnie, your date has arrived.
Oh, thank you, Sanjay. Send him in.
Very awkward.
Mr. Warbucks is upstairs. Who could be at the door?
Beats me. I'm just as confused as you.
Senor Enrique San Antonio Hernandez Iglesias Fernando the Third.
Hola, señorita bonitas. Excuse me. Hello, beautiful ladies. Miss GrAnnie, these flores are for you.
Oh, sunflowers. My favorite. How did you know?
Your eyes, they told me when we first met.
Alice, would you put these in water, please? Ricky,
you have such a beautiful accent. Where are you from?
Well, originally, I was born and raised in Barcelona near the Aran Sea. And mi papa, he used to take me fishing by the peninsula. It was very close to where we live, you see.
Your accent, it almost sounds Russian.
Russian, yes. You see, I used to travel a lot to Moscow for business, you see. And while I was there, I pick up accent, you know. So my accent, how you say, sometimes comes and goes.
Moscow? I studied in Moscow for 8 years. What part of Moscow?
What part?
Yeah.
Moscow. It's a very small city. So small, it's technically not even really a city yet. But you can't even find it on a map, you know. Granny, we have a reservation. I think that we should be going. We do not want to be late. Das Pedania and adios.
Oh, thank you. It was nice meeting you.
Have a good time.
Night. I can't wait to hear about it on Monday morning.
Why is everyone standing around here when there's so much work to be done?
Yes.
Get back to work, please.
Just the person I was looking for. Would you mind accompanying me to my office? I'd like to have a word with you.
Of course.
Have a seat, Hope. You know I'm a man of few words, and though I may have a difficult time expressing my inner feelings, there's something I need to talk with you about.
You can tell me anything, William. You know that, don't you?
Yes, and that's precisely why I can't go beyond this room.
Oh, I've always respected your privacy.
Hope, what are your thoughts on inner office romances?
Excuse me?
Well, the thing is, Hope, I have feelings for a member of my staff, and I'm not quite sure how to let this person know. I don't want it to affect our working relationship. I'm conflicted. But I think I may be falling for this individual.
Oh, I see. Well, she may already suspect that you have feelings for her. Women tend to know these things. Women's intuition, you know. What is it about her that you find so attractive?
Well, she's brought light into my house and laughter into my life ever since the first moment she stepped in my home. Oh, she's smart and funny and, well, if I may be so frank to say, very pleasant to the eye.
Oh, William, I don't know what to say.
I spent a lot of time getting to know her and, well, I think I'm ready to ask her out on a date.
A date? I believe she would love that. It may be that she's even been waiting for you to ask.
You really think so, Hope?
As I said before, William, a woman knows these things.
So you think I should ask her?
What are you waiting for?
You're right. What am I waiting for? I'm going to ask her right now. Hope?
Yes, William?
Do you know where Grannie is? I want to catch her before she leaves for the weekend.
Grannie?
Yes. Hope, thank you so much for this talk. You are the best. Oh, yeah, can you finish editing my speech for the mayor's ball? I'm going to need that on my desk first thing in the morning.
Yes.
Thank you.
Sir.
You don't see me.
here's to you now. Give me your chance, and I'll let you see how nothing has changed. Deep in my heart, I'm concealing things I want to say. Scared to confess what I'm feeling.
Have you seen GrAnnie? I'd like to have a word with her. There's something I want to ask her.
Oh, I'm so sorry. She has left for the weekend. You just missed her. Her ride picked her up.
Her ride?
Yes, a Russian or Spanish gentleman. he was taking her out on a date, and he seemed to be charming her.
Oh, I see. Well, thank you, Alice.
Is there anything wrong, sir?
No. Thank you for the information. You know, why don't you take the rest of the evening off and tell the rest of the staff they can leave early as well. I suddenly have a headache, and I think I'll retire early.
Take care. Get some rest.
Hola. I would like a table for two, por favor.
Do you have a reservation?
Do I have a reservation? Of course I have a reservation. It is under the name Lincoln.
I'm sorry, there is no reservation for Lincoln.
No. Check again. It might be under the name Hamilton.
Does Hamilton have a brother?
A brother? Right, Osmilo, a brother. Fine, okay. Yeah.
Thank you.
Table for two, please.
Hamilton, party of two, please follow me. May I show you the wine?
The wine list, yes, por favor, thank you. Would you pass?
Yes.
Ah, yes.
I just love this place. My boss, William, Mr. Warbucks, he owns it.
Oh, yes, I have read in the newspaper about the Warbucks family. I am very sorry to hear about his father passing. And I was reading in the business section that the Warbucks Incorporation is not doing so good. Something about Shop 11, but what do I know? I do not know nothing. All I know is that this night is all about you.
Good evening. Oh, what a beautifully matched couple you are.
Yes.
Can I interest you in our specials tonight?
Oh, most definitely.
No, I know what I want.
Oh, very good.
I'm going to start with the lobster bisque.
Wonderful.
I'll have the duck blanc with risotto and glazed Brussels sprouts. Mm-hmm. And then for dessert, flaming bananas. Ooh. Foster.
Very nice. Yes. And for you, sir?
Flaming bananas Foster. Yeah. Jess, I will have the salad.
All right, the salad, of course. What size, sir?
Small.
Of course, that makes perfect sense.
I will also have a water, part of two waters.
And what size, sir?
Large.
Two large waters.
We'll have that out for you just as quickly as we can.
We just got this.
Walkie-talkie.
You look so lovely tonight.
Thank you.
I just want you to know that I have planned something very special for you.
For me?
Yes, for you.
Oh.
I just want you to sit down, look oh so beautiful, and know that this is all for you.
Strangers in the night, exchanging glances, wandering in the night. What were the chances we'd be sharing love before the night was through? Something in your eyes was so exciting, something in your smile was so inviting, something in my heart told me I must have you. Strangers in the night, two lonely people, we were strangers in the night. Up to that moment when we said our first hello, little did we know, love was just a glance away, a warm embracing dance away.
Is over. I believe that I am your density. how you say, my English is so-so, yes, my destiny. Miss GrAnnie? Will you be my wife? Is that a Jess?
Jess, 1,000 times Jess!
She said Jess! She said Jess!
Thank you.
I didn't expect you to be up this late.
Yeah, I couldn't sleep. You look different. I love the red hair.
Thank you.
Did you have a nice evening?
Oh, it was wonderful. We ate at your restaurant, saw a wonderful show, danced the night away. It was incredible.
Well, I'm happy for you. You deserve to have a good time and a special night.
Oh, it certainly was special. And what made it even more special? Enrique proposed. Yet I'm going to be Mrs. Enrique San Antonio Hernandez Fernando Ricky Martin Julio Iglesias.
Proposed? Wow. That's, I mean, so soon?
Oh, well, he said that at our age, we don't know how much time we have, so why wait?
Are you sure about this, Granny? I mean, are you ready to get married again?
Enrique and I really seem to have a lot in common, and he really knows me, even though we've always only been on one date. I know it's fast, but I don't know when I'm going to get another chance.
I wish you'd take more time making this decision. I mean, what do you really know about this Enrique Iglesias?
Well, I know that he's my ticket out of that horrible place that I'm living in, and he seems to love me, and I'll be good to him, and I'm willing to settle for the best that I could get.
Do you love him?
Love isn't everything. Well, I'll have a very different life with him.
It looks like you've made up your mind. I just want the best for you, and well, if you're happy, then I'm happy. And as my wedding gift to you, and I won't take no for an answer, I'd be honored if you'd allow me to host this special occasion right here in my home, and I'll incur all the expenses.
Oh, I don't even know what to say.
You don't have to say anything. I just want you to be happy.
Thank you, Billy.
You're welcome, Granny.
Good night.
Have worked out much better than planned. It makes you smile when fate takes a hand. I know I'll forget how she walked into my life and how she was almost mine.
Do you have
everyone. It's almost time. We hope you understand. Your wishes are command. We're gonna have a wedding here.
Places.
Charming, handsome, exotic lover, and he conned you into marrying him under false pretense.
Oh, what's going on, Enrique? I don't understand.
My love, this is some sort of a mistake. I would never do such things to you.
I now pronounce you.
No. Miss Hannigan, don't say a word. You're under arrest for elder abuse, fraud, tax evasion, and theft.
I did all that. Let go of me. Get your filthy hands off me. Oh, on second hand, let your filthy hands do things to me. I haven't seen this much action in years.
Oh, wait a minute. Did you say that his name was Rooster Hannigan?
That's right. These two are a brother and sister auntie. They have been stealing from the residents of Sunset Meadows for years.
Oh, is this true? Oh.
Look, I'm really sorry about all this, Granny. But when Rooster came to pick you up the other night, Sanjay suspected that he wasn't who he really was. Sanjay, being the world traveler he is, he noticed that Enrique's accent was a bit muddy.
You dirty, filthy scoundrel! You said you were from Barcelona near the Elborn Sea. However, Barcelona is nowhere near the Elborn Sea. The Elborn Sea is near the southernmost peninsula of Spain, whereas Barcelona is on the northeast part of the country.
Oh, God.
When Sanjay came to me with his suspicions, I immediately called a good friend of mine at the FBI. It seems they've been after Rooster Hannigan for years. And during their investigation, they discovered he was the brother of Miss Hannigan. And the two of them have been doing scams for years.
Rooster, is this true?
Don't play dumb, baby.
Who's playing?
You are in on it the whole time.
Don't call me baby. It's Detective Diamond.
What?
That's right. I've been working this case for the last 8 months. I knew that the way to get to your sister was through you. I figured if you fell in love, you'd be more likely to spill the beans. I was just waiting for you two to pull off one more big successful job, so I put you both in the slammer for a long time.
But you said you loved me.
I said a lot of things. Stop. I can't believe you fell for that little chicken nuggets feather brain scheme. Well, this chicken is gonna put you two turkeys in the hen house. Take them away.
I'm so sorry for all this. I hope you understand why I did this. I never meant to hurt you.
Well, I'm less hurt by the fact that he lied to me and more hurt that I was too blind to see it. I am done with that man.
Well, maybe you can put all of this behind you and move on with your life.
Well, yes. I'm certainly looking forward to getting back to work.
Oh, about that. I have some bad news. I've never been the businessman my father was. I've made some bad investments, and I just couldn't keep the Warbucks estate going. In short, I've lost all my money, and I have to sell the entire Warbucks estate. I'm broke.
Oh, my.
Sorry I'm late. What? Oh, wait. Wait. Oh, I was done. Oh, goodness. Wait, you can't get married yet. I was down in Miss Hannigan's basement looking through all our letters from our family, and I told you she was hiding our letters. She was a letter hoarder, and she's a liar. Granny, I found this. You need to see this.
Oh, my. Okay. Final will and testament. I, Chester Hampton, being of sound mind and body, do hereby bequeath my entire estate of $15 billion to my favorite niece, Betty Jane. I'm rich. I'm just not rich. I'm stinking rich. It would seem to me that I'm even richer than you. Having said that, Billy, will you marry me?
Jess, I will marry you. I mean, it'd be a shame to waste a really great wedding like this, right?
That's right.
Yeah. Oh, Granny, I love you.
I love you, too. Truth be told, it's always been you.
But wait a minute. Who's going to perform the ceremony?
Oh,
I can do it. Yeah. Besides being a belly dancer for Bollywood actors, I also happen to be a licensed wedding official.
Oh.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are gathered here to join these two people that should have been joined together in the first place. Do you, Betty Granny James, take William Shirley Warbucks to be your lawfully wedded husband?
Shirley?
Don't call me Shirley. Just answer the man.
I do.
Oh, good, good. Then do you, William Shirley Warbucks, take Betty Granny James to be your lawfully wedded wife?
Oh, I do.
Then, at this time, I would like you to share your vows. William, why don't you go first, sir?
GrAnnie, ever since the moment you stepped into my office, I knew you were applying for more than a job. You were applying for a permanent position in my heart. You brought such life and joy into my life and into my home. I couldn't see living out the rest of my days with anyone else.
I never thought I would get another chance at love and happiness. You are everything I could want in a man and a husband. I promise to love and cherish you all the years of my life. Billy, you have changed me in so many ways, but I'm still not cooking for you.
I wouldn't have it any other way.
Oh, goody, goody gumdrop. Are the powers vested in me by the mighty Lord Ganesh? I now pronounce you husband and wife, even to step right. Oh. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my distinct honor to introduce to you, for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Warbucks!
Together at last, together forever, we're tying a knot they never can sever. I don't need sunshine now to turn my skies to blue. I don't need anything but you.
Yesterday was plain awful.
You can say that again.
Yesterday was plain awful.
But that's not now, that's then. You wrap me around that cute little finger. You made life a song. Maybe the singer.
And what's that bathtub tune you always?
Boo, boo, boo. I don't need anything, anything, anything.
I don't
need anything but you.
Richard, with the Warbucks adventure, they'll break the middle name, Turino. Together, they open the little off-Broadway theater. happily ever after.